from Taiwan. I'm listening to Liao with news from here in Taiwan and around the world. Executives from U.S. drone companies are in Taiwan looking for local corporate partners. Their visit comes as Taiwan's defense ministry confirms it's testing a domestically developed first-person view drone. These kinds of drones are meant to be faster and more maneuverable, Louise Watt reports.
A new focus of Taiwan's armed forces. Soldiers are remotely testing drones carrying explosives. They are first-person view or FPV drones, controlled by an operator in real time through special glasses. Small drones like these have become a key weapon in Ukraine's war against Russia.
FPV 无人机因为它的速度以及它的这种操纵性的，就是又更进一步提升，所以它经常被用于改装携带反装甲武器等等的去作为攻击对方车辆或者载具的一种重要的平台。
China claims sovereignty over democratic Taiwan and has been stepping up its military pressure in recent years. Taiwan has been building up its drone manufacturing capabilities as part of an asymmetric war strategy to give it the best shot at resisting an enemy with much more firepower. And according to the UK's Financial Times, Taiwan and US drone companies are now looking to work together to create a drone supply chain that does not rely on China, which has the world's biggest drone industry. More than 20 executives from US drone manufacturers are in Taiwan on a four-day trip looking for partners. It's a chance for Taiwan to deepen cooperation with its most important international backer, as well as give its forces a better chance on the battlefield. Klein Wong and Louise Watt for Taiwan Plus.
Taiwan's French-made Mirage 2000 fighter jets have taken to the skies once again after being grounded for 2 weeks. The Air Force grounded its aging Mirage fleet after losing one of the jets at sea due to power failure. The pilot of that aircraft managed to eject successfully and was rescued in the ocean. The Air Force says that it has finished inspecting its fleet of Mirages and that the planes are clear to fly. The Mirage 2000 is one of four combat jets Taiwan flies. Confirmed cases of dengue fever have popped up in northern Taiwan, sparking concerns over the spread of the disease. All five cases of the mosquito-borne disease were confirmed in New Taipei City. Authorities have closed off areas that run a high risk of infection, and pest control teams have been dispatched to spray mosquito breeding areas. China's central bank has announced stimulus measures to fight deflation and disappointing economic performance. It plans to reduce the amount of cash banks need to hold in reserve, freeing up around 140 billion US dollars for banks to lend. It's also cutting mortgage rates and the central bank's own lending rate. Chinese stocks and bonds rose after the announcement. Depending on the situation later in the year, interest rates for loans may be lowered even more. For more on China's new stimulus measures, our reporter Jeremy Olivier spoke to Alicia Garcia Herrero, chief economist for Asia Pacific at Natixis.
The overall goal of this new raft of stimulus measures is to hit China's 5% GDP growth target for this year. But taken apart individually, what does each of the measures do exactly?
Well, the cut in the reserve requirement ratio, this RRR, as we know it by now, is all about liquidity. So liquidity is very important because there's an increasing lack of liquidity in the banking sector in some areas, especially for those exposed to developers. The developers are a small amount of total loans, but for some small banks, you know, they were very exposed. And more importantly, local governments, real estate from the local governments is literally seven times larger than developers. So just to give you a sense of the dimension of. And because many of these vehicles are not really paying back, banks are, you know, starting to feel the pinch. Then the cut on the loan prime rate, which is the benchmark for mortgages, I think that's long overdue as inflation is high. In China, real interest rates are very high because there's deflation, at least in producer prices, in GDP prices. And in CPI, it's basically close to zero. Thus, mortgages are hard to finance because of this situation.
China, of course, has been facing a number of very difficult economic challenges. It has been for months. So how aggressive would you say that these new measures are in addressing those issues, especially compared with how the Central Bank of China has acted in the past?
It's not aggressive yet. Bear in mind that there's so many things that they need to do. This is just the beginning, in my view. I mean, if you want to see a major change in growth prospects, you need to see much more. Just a note that interest rates or sovereign bond yields continue to go down. Yes, stock market is going up. That's a good signal. But stock markets compared to the bond market signal do react to any sign of stimulus because they're starving for it, if you see what I mean. I mean, that sign doesn't mean it's sustainable. It only means that they're happy about the temporary stimulus.
What other steps do you think should be taken by China as it seeks to improve its economic performance for this year?
I think they need to design a comprehensive program. They need to say they're going to spend on fiscal. How? I would expect them to say it's targeted to the consumer, so not just infra expenditure or just, you know, additional issuance of local government bonds as they usually do, quotas. I mean, that, no, we need to know where they're spending the money, and that must be the consumer.
That was Natixis Chief Asia Pacific Economist Alicia Garcia Herrero. Architectural designers and environmental startups in Germany are teaming up to create a structure that helps bring both comfort and environmental benefits to city dwellers. Irene Lin takes a look.
This wooden structure might be the best new hideout from a scorching hot day in the city. The display at the London Design Festival is called the Vert. It uses 25 species of annual climbing plants that provide shelter and a cooling effect. Stefan Dietz, a designer based in Munich, Germany, is behind this creation.
In Vert, we are growing yearly plants, yearly fast-growing plants like morning glory, some kind of beans and hops, for instance. They grow up to 10 meters in 1 year, providing shadow, evaporation, a cool breeze.
Rapid urbanization and climate change has turned some parts of the cities into what climatologists call heat islands. Densely populated concrete jungles that easily trap heat. For the London Design Festival, Dietz teamed up with the Office of Microclimate Cultivation, based in Frankfurt, Germany, which specializes in developing greening solutions for urban areas. Its co-founder explained another sustainable use for the vegetation in the structure as an energy source.
As these climbing plants are based on a seasonal cycle, what we do in autumn is that we harvest the whole biomass, and then depending on the local infrastructure, we can, for example, turn them into compost, energy, or even biochar. And by that, return the whole harvested biomass into the economic cycle.
Beyond the hard science and activism, Dietz says the structure easily integrates itself into people's daily lives.
This structure is, in a way, constructed like a street furniture. It's like a shelf that you put onto a place or on the street so the cars can still pass underneath, the bicycle can go underneath, people can still walk, but they can also sit and rest. And we want to offer a lot of things that people can do without that they have to immediately change their habits.
The team says the structure can help create a symbiotic relationship between humans and the environment in an urban space and show people how saving the planet can be done with little disturbance and also with comfort and taste. Alex Chen and Irene Lin for TaiwanPlus.
And we'd like to thank you for watching What's Up Taiwan. You can visit the TaiwanPlus website or follow our social media for more stories from Taiwan and around the world. Finally, check out these images from Mexico City, where over 20 bands gathered for a 10-hour mariachi marathon over the weekend. I'm Leslie Liao. Take care and see you next time.